Hey, Adam Savage here in my cave with a tool tip that I can't believe I haven't showed you before. I think I've talked about it on some of my builds, but I haven't done an official let's get into this tool tip about what I'm about to show you. I am a machine operator. I can use my mill and my lathe here in the shop to produce parts like this trigger here. Now, this is a part that I machine. It's some machining in here. There's some sanding. There's some post-processing. But this is a chunk of brass. So in doing these operations, I rely on a bunch of different tools for measuring and marking. But marking holds a special place within the practice of machining. If you want to cut this trigger out of, let's say, this chunk of aluminum, just for the sake of the argument for this tool tip, let's say I wanted to cut a trigger of this shape out of this piece of aluminum. You can see that the piece of aluminum itself is big enough to accommodate it. But what do I do? Do I grab one of my Pica markers and sit there and trace it like this? No. Do you know why? Well, because it's just not accurate enough. I can cut to this line, sure. I can cut close to that line and I can keep measuring. But when I am shaping stuff that has mission critical dimensions, even a thin Sharpie doesn't even come close enough. Plus, when things get heated, Sharpie tends to fade away under heat, so that doesn't work. No, today's tool tip is all about a thing that is one of my favorite things since I learned about it. It's called marking fluid. This is made by Dykem. They are the primary manufacturer. There must be others, but I don't know their names. Layout fluid is effectively a transparent blue lacquer that dries quickly. And you coat metal parts with it, and then you scribe into those metal parts using a scribe like this one. This one is made by Steroid. We will include links to both of these in the comments below. We'll talk about the scribe in a minute, but first the marking fluid. And let me get a close-up here so you can see what's going on. You start with your piece of metal and you would clean it just to make sure that it is free of marks and oil and dust and stuff like that. There we go. Then you take your marking fluid, and they make a spray marking fluid, but I prefer the stuff that comes in the bottle here. It's got its own integral brush. And you just paint the marking fluid on your work, and you can see it creates a really nice, even blue field. Oh, look at that. A quick hit from a blow dryer. Sets it nice and right. And then, so now you can see that my surface is coated really evenly and really thinly. And what the marking fluid allows me to do is it allows me to make marks that pierce the marking fluid, but not the metal. So I make little marks, and I can use those marks to machine to and to give myself reference points. But when I clean off the marking fluid, I don't end up with scribe marks in the metal itself. So let me show you kind of how marks might get made. Here we go. Put down a straight edge, make a mark. Put down another straight edge. Ooh, bumped my thumb. So you can see, now I've gone a little bit deep on a couple of these. You see how much more precise that is than something like, yeah, see that? That's not a line I can cut to. That is a line I can cut to. Acetone washes this right off, so does paint thinner. Now, the scribe. Let's talk about the scribe. There are lots of different kinds of scribes. Well, like this is often sold as a scribe for $7 or $8. These are fine. I don't think these are as sharp as they could be. I have a really old one that I bought at a flea market years ago. This one's been hand sharpened, and I have resharpened it myself many times. This is a Steroid. This is a Steroid Scribe, and it actually has the ability to replace the scribe tip. That's a really nice feature. I really dig that feature. And more than that, I really like the way this feels. It's a really good feeling scribe. Why is the way the scribe feels really important? Look, if you're just starting out and you have the most common question everyone who's starting out in making things has, which is, what should I spend my money on? What are the most important tools for me to get? And the answer is always, it depends on all sorts of factors. In general, when you're starting out, you don't have a lot of money and you have a lot of time. So materials are the expensive part of the equation and your time is the inexpensive part. That's great because you're going to use a lot of that time to make a lot of mistakes and get some experience. Later on, as you start to get better, you will notice that some of the tools you've been relying on can't perform to the level that you need them to. Now you have a bigger consciousness about them, and now it's time to invest in the better versions of those tools. Now, you can't go buy the best version of every tool. I mean, I know there are some people that can, but pretty much that's impossible. You'd never stop spending money. So what do you spend your money on? Well, spend your money on tools that are going to serve you for a lifetime. And, you know, while Steroid makes these for, I think, as little as $17 and as much as $50 or $60, depending on the make and the model of their scribe. And like I said, we'll include some links in the comments below. The fact is that Steroid makes lifetime equipment. They are one of those manufacturers like Brown & Sharpe and Mitutoyo. When you buy one of their things, you expect to use it for decades. And when you're buying a tool that can last that long, to me, it's not too, like, look, this scribe may be $7 or $8, and you could do 98% of what you can do with this with it. But this isn't a lifetime tool. It doesn't feel like it. There's an aspect to it that's just a little too light, a little too cheap. But this is an investment in your future. I'm not saying you need to go spend $60, but I'm saying spend $21 on a scribe. Even though that might seem like a lot, when you're using it, it's going to feel great and it's going to give you a better tactile attachment to your tools. So it's kind of a way of sort of peeking above the clouds. All of my entry-level Steroid pieces, like my tap wrench, we did a video about that tap wrench a few weeks ago, and some of my squares and things like that, they all just feel so good because this is a company devoted, like I said, to making lifetime tools. So get yourself some marking fluid, use it to do some precise marking up of your work. I almost forgot this one, like, super important thing. So you don't just make layout lines in order to give yourself a cut point. If you're machining to, you know, if you're machining to high precision, these marks are still just guides, but they're really important guides. So if I chucked just this raw piece of aluminum and I knew I wanted to take off, like, let's say exactly 3/4 of an inch off the top, I can make a mark that's roughly 3/4 of an inch and get close to that. But if I use my marking fluid and I precisely measure, where is my calipers? If I take my calipers, set them to exactly 3/4 of an inch, and I use them to scribe myself that 3/4 of an inch line. Here we go. There's the line. Then, also, and if you're taking material away, you want to actually make marks that make it clear what you are removing. See that? That tells me I removed that part, but not that part. I know that seems like, how would you not know? The fact is, for any like weirdly sophisticated part of with multiple angles and multiple mountings in order to machine it all, you can easily lose track of where you are. And layout lines and hash marks letting you know what you're removing and what you're not, and marks that tell you when you're close to the measurement you want to be at, these become super vital. The number of times I have messed up a part because I thought it was simple and didn't require layout, I now do layout for everything I chuck into the mill unless it is a single cut. Yeah, it's that game changing. So Dykem makes a spray marking fluid. They make it in red and they make it in blue. I have found over the years that I prefer the marking abilities of the actual fluid, not the spray. So while I have it, this is my preferred method. So get thyself some blue marking fluid and a scribe and start the holy laying out of things. Thank you guys for joining me for this tool tip. I will see you next time.